Hello, my name is Justin Beigel, and in this video we will be covering a brief introduction to the TIDA-060039 reference design. This design implements inductive touch buttons and a magnetic Hall effect dial for a human-machine interface. There are 8 inductive touch buttons on this reference design as shown here. Inductive touch allows for this design to provide a seamless touch surface without any mechanical cutouts, as well as a forced touch response for the button surface. The Hall effect magnetic dial is in the center of the design and can give rotational data and be used as an additional push button. This magnetic dial is also a contactless implementation, which reduces potential wear and tear when compared to contact-based rotation sensing. There are 3 groups of LEDs on this design. The first group is used to display the button states. How these LEDs display the button information changes based on the operational mode. To see the current operational mode, the 2 LEDs on the right can be used. These will always correlate to the current operational mode. The last group of LEDs displays the position of the magnetic dial as one of 12 angle increments. For full documentation on this design, you can visit its product page on TI.com. Implementing the 8 inductive touch buttons on this design was done by utilizing 2 LDC3114 devices. This IC has 4 channels for sensor coils, but needs an I2C switch to be able to use multiple devices with the same microcontroller I2C bus. The mechanical aspect of this button is implemented using a 3D printed housing and a thin metal target adhered between the button surface and sensor coil. When force is applied to the button surface, the metal target bends towards the sensor coil and is detected as a force response or button press depending on the operational mode of the MCU of this design. More information on that later. For more general information on inductive touch buttons, please visit our E2E FAQ page linked on this slide. The magnetic dial is implemented using a single TMAG5273. This device is a 3-axis Hall effect sensor with an integrated cortic algorithm. This provides the angle of the magnetic field through a register read and removes the need to perform any angle calculations by the MCU. The 3rd axis of the device is used to detect the push on the dial. This is implemented by using a spring to hold the dial in place until a force is applied to the top of the dial. When the dial is pushed in, the magnetic field strength is compared to a threshold to determine a push event. Now that the components of the design have been broken down, the operational modes can be discussed. The way that the inductive touch buttons are handled changes between operational modes in this design. To switch between the modes, the push button on the dial is used. In the default mode, each of the inductive touch buttons will correlate to one of the button LEDs. The digital outputs of the LDC3114 channels are used to turn on the LEDs. The LDC3114 has a max win algorithm that is applied on each device, so only one button per device can be sensed at a time. This feature is enabled on this design to eliminate any impact of the mechanical crosstalk between buttons. The second operational mode provides a forced touch response on the button LEDs. The harder a button press, the more LEDs will light up. Only one button can be pressed at a time in this mode, so if 2 buttons are pressed, the stronger response will be shown on the LEDs. The last 2 modes are used in conjunction with the design's GUI. The raw data for each LDC can be seen in each mode respectively. Now that we've gone over the design, here's a brief demonstration of the design in action. In the first operational mode, each inductive touch button correlates to one of the LEDs. Pressing on 2 buttons of the same side will only light up 1 LED due to the settings chosen for the internal algorithm, but 1 button from each side can be pressed at the same time since they are operated by separate ICs. The center dial displays the current magnet angle on the circle of the LEDs in the top right of the design. Pressing on the dial will change the operational mode, and the design will now display the force of the button pressed on the LEDs instead. The harder you press, the more LEDs will light up. Only the strongest button press will be displayed on the LEDs in this mode. Pressing on the dial again brings the design into the left button GUI mode. In this mode, the EVM can communicate to the GUI and show the raw data of each button on the left side of the design. When the GUI is collecting data, all other functions of the designs are suspended. The dial angle and press will not work. After stopping the data collection, the dial can be pressed again to change to the right side buttons. Clearing the graph between operational modes gives a cleaner view of the data from each side. Then the data can be collected the same way it was for the left side. When done, pressing the dial again will bring the device back into the first operational mode. Thanks for watching. For more information on inductive and magnetic Hall effect sensing, please visit ti.com/LDC and ti.com/Hall, respectively.